Perlin. I'm one of the CPAs at Powell & Jones CPAs, and it's a pleasure to be here, but see all you guys out here in the town, or city, being active and involved in what's going on here, and being interested in what the numbers are, and seeing how the year turned out for 2017. Richard Norwood's here. You guys are probably all familiar with him. He's been delivering this audio for quite a while, but I'll be filling in for him today because he had another arrangement going on. If you would turn to page 5. On page 5, you'll find our independent audit report, which this is kind of the summary of the overall whether the financial statements are accurately stated. And if you look down at the bottom, it says, in our opinion, the financial statements referred to above present fairly in all material respects the respective financial position and governmental activities and so on. Basically all the financial information in this report we certify is true and correct within reasonable levels. Now, I just want to go ahead and thank Leanne and all she does. You know, she does a lot of hard work here. You know, really almost 2 or 3 jobs in most other cities this size. She does a really good job and keeps really good records. And it's because of that that we're able to have this highest opinion, the unqualified opinion on these financial statements. Now, if you would turn to page 7. This is the management discussion analysis. This section of the report discusses the basic position of the city. It gives a little analysis on some changes that happened during the year. But we're going to go into the more nitty-gritty financial statements here in a second, and then we'll be talking about everything that's in there. But if you'd like to go back and reread that for your own benefit, we can do that after the fact. If you turn to page 17 now. This is the governmental funds balance sheet. Now, in governmental accounting, there's kind of 2 different standards. There's the governmental fund accounting, and then there's the enterprise accounting. And for the one, you're is more like a cash basis, more so it's more modified accrual. And that's what this governmental fund is. And the reason for that is to keep it kind of on track with the budget. Now, you have 5 different governmental funds. These are listed here. You have your general fund, your law enforcement provision fund, your special revenues fund, your water sewer impact fee fund, and your community redevelopment fund. All these together make up the total governmental funds on the right-hand column. You can see the first line there is cash and cash equivalents. At year end, you had $699,000 in cash and cash equivalents for your governmental funds. You have total assets, just below that, of $965,000. You have total liabilities, which is what you owe out, of $150,000. And if you look at each one of these 5 funds, each of them has a fund balance at the end. These are divided up into restricted and unassigned fund balances. These represent kind of like the total value, if you would say, of these different funds. And you look at the first one, general fund, you have $642,000 in unrestricted fund balance there. What that means is unrestricted means you can use it for basically anything you need. So and this $642,000 represents approximately 2.5 months of expenditures out of general fund. So if anything happened, you guys somehow, probably this would never happen, but you know, you didn't have any revenue coming in, it would last you about 2.5 months. Now for a city your size, you might want to increase that. Some cities your size have usually 3 to 6 months is a good goal to have in unrestricted fund balances to have for future needs, just in case of emergency situations arise.
Is there any state suggestion?
No, there's no like official like rule or suggestion on that, but it's up to the commission to determine what they think is necessary for future risks and stuff like
that. That would cover really something with the wastewater plant that would replace 100,000 wouldn't be an unusual expense.
you know, and that's what that unrestricted is for. Some of this is the general fund, so that's not really okay. Used for the, we'll get to the wastewater and that in a minute.
Okay.
So you got that unrestricted balance. The other funds are all restricted balances. Their monies have been set aside for being spent on a specific purpose. And those total to $172,000. And when you take all of the fund balances in total at year end, your total governmental fund balances are $815,000. Okay, let's turn to the next page, page 18. This is state of revenues, expenditures, and changes in fund balance. This is like the change that happened during the year. So from October 1 to September 30, 1 year, this is what it is. This is a snapshot. If you look in the first column, general fund, the third number up from the bottom, you'll see the net change in fund balances for the year. It was $424,000. Now this took your starting fund balance, which was $218,000, and increased it to the $642,000 on the bottom line for general fund. And that's the $642,000 we just talked about a minute ago, the unrestricted fund balances. In total, for all of the governmental funds, you had an increase of $346,000, bringing your total fund balances of all governmental funds to $815,000.
Is that good or bad?
Oh, that's sufficient for what you need. Like I said earlier, that you have that, at least you have the 2.5 months, but it's something that could be grown in the future.
But you would recommend more than 2.5 months,
right? I mean, it's like a two and a half months is a little lower than average, is what I would say.
When you say lower than average, what do you mean?
Of cities your size that we audit.
What other cities do you audit?
We audit Port Ritchie is one of them. I'm trying to think of the other larger ones off the top of my head. But yeah, there's several other small cities that
We're not bad, but we're not real good.
Yeah, it's not a crisis.
Okay.
Okay. But yep. So what we have on this next page 20, is the proprietary fund. Now this is like your business type activities. So this is stuff outside of like just strictly governmental functions. This is like selling water, sewer, gas, your purchasing department, and sanitation. That's what's all included in this proprietary fund. This is the balance sheet, which provides a snapshot of the economic balances at year end. If you look on the first number there, cash and cash equivalents, you have $1.6 million in cash and cash equivalents. The total current assets, which include other assets that you have in there besides cash, is $1.9 million. And then next down, you have your non-current assets, which is restricted cash and investments. Now, those are restricted for debt payment and other things like that. And if you take that cash balance and your investments and add that to your unrestricted balance, you come up to about a total of $2.2 million in cash in your business type activities here. If you look further down, you'll see your fixed assets section. At year end, you have $7.6 million net in your fixed assets. And your total current liabilities, which means liabilities that should be coming due within the next year, is $331,000. Your long-term liabilities are $3.6 million, $3.4 of which are your water and sewer bonds that you have outstanding. So that's the large chunk of that. Now, similar to general fund, you have different restrictions of your fund balance. Your net position. It's similar to the fund balance in general fund. Now, it's split up into three different categories. You have invested in capital assets, net of related debt, restricted for debt service, and unrestricted categories here. The invested in capital assets is almost $4 million, and that represents the amount of your fund balance that's tied up. You can't access it because it's reflected in that assets, capital assets. So unless if you sold all your equipment, you wouldn't be able to access that money. Restricted for debt service is that $630,000 I talked about previously to set aside for future debt payments. And then you have your unrestricted balance, which is $1.6 million, and that reflects the total amount of money that can meet your future ongoing needs on a day-to-day basis, because it can be used for whatever you need. And if you take the total expenses for the year and divide that out, you got about half a year's worth in that unrestricted. So that means something happened when you didn't have any money coming in, you could last about half a year, which is a pretty significant reserve for your business funds. Okay, if you turn to the next page, page 21. This is the statement of revenue and expenses. This shows, similar to the general fund, the activity for the whole entire year from October 1 to September 30, the money you took in and the money that went out. You can see that your total operating revenues in the first section there is $4 million. You turn to the next page. You'll see the towards the bottom there's a total operating expenses underneath the sewer area, and you'll see that the total operating expenses for all of your business type activities are around $3 million, which leaves your net operating income at about almost $1 million in operating income there. But that was before your transfers, and you can see the non-operating revenues, you can see some expenses, you can see the $1.3 million in inter-fund transfers, which is money that was sent over to the general fund to help the general fund fund its ongoing operations.
I mentioned to the city clerk an issue that one on page 22. Yeah, maybe it was above my pay grade, but there was something that I just looked at it with that total sewer and then the total operating expenses, operating income, it almost looked like there should have been a space there.
But yeah, that's what we got there in bold, so you can try to tell the difference. And we can fix that for next year if you like, so that would be.
Yeah, I just looked at it and I thought it didn't seem quite right. But then that's above my pay grade.
So anyway, so you have operating income of almost $1 million, but that $1.3 million transfer out and some other expenses in there that are non-operating related, which leaves your overall net at $468,000 in negative there. So those transfers reduce the operating balances of the proprietary funds this year. So the starting balance was $6.6 million, and it went to reduced to $6.2 million at year end. And that reduction, though, of the 468 is approximately due to the depreciation on your assets, because that's like a non-cash expense. So you'll see what the actual cash flows is, or just reflect on the next page. And we'll explain that a little bit more. Page 23, you got your cash received from customers. That's the money that you took in for your water, sewer, and other business activity sales of $4 million. And then you had your payments out for goods of $1.4 million. And then you had $1 million that went out for employee wages and other related stuff. So when you take that and you take the transfers out, which is a little bit higher than the number we saw on the other page, because of some inter-fund balances that were owed in the year before, you come down and you take out some of the capital-related items for equipment that was purchased, you come to a net reduction of cash of $109,000 during the year. Now, $385,000 of that represents payments on your debt and purchases of capital assets. Okay, let's turn over to the next page. This is the net position statement for the fiduciary funds. And fiduciary funds are basically ones that hold other people's money. In this case, it holds the retirement funds for the police and firefighters' pensions. If you look down the second to last number, net position available for benefits, $5.1 million is available for that future benefits for police and firemen as of year end. Let's turn over to the next page, page 25. On the third number up from the bottom, this is a net increase in net position available for benefits. So those benefits that we talked about earlier, they increased $299,000 from $4.8 million to $5.1 million. Okay. Let's turn to the next page. This is the beginning of the notes of financial statements. In here is a bunch of information that explains a lot of the numbers in the financial statements that help clarify things and provide more detail. There's a lot of information here, so we're not going to hit on all of it. But if you go ahead and turn to page 42. Here you can see the capital assets note 7. This is broken up into two sections. You've got your governmental activities and business type activities, just like those statements we had earlier. This divides it up. This shows the total amount of assets in each category that you have. Total for your governmental activities is going to be $10 million in assets. And those assets, of that $10 million, $5.4 million of it was depreciated. So that's kind of, the depreciation shows like how much of those assets are used up. So about half of it is of the useful life of those assets are used up. It's 54% depreciated. As you try to keep up with assets, about 50%, and maybe even a little lower is a good target to be going for to keep your assets relatively fresh. The business type activities has $19.4 million in total assets, and $11.7 million of that is depreciated, which is 61% depreciated. Overall, the total net assets for those business type activities, or the net assets, is $7.6 million after depreciation. Okay, let's turn a couple pages over, 345, page 45. This is the long-term debt schedule here. This shows on the top is the governmental activities, and below is the business type activities. You can see all the long-term liabilities is what your city owes out in the future. And you can see that the total for governmental long-term debt is $1.7 million. Most of that balance is what's reflected in net pension liability. This is nothing that you're going to have to pay anytime, and there's no, you guys have kept up your obligations to make your payments on the pension plan. This is just an actuarial calculation that someone comes up with, and they take all the future benefits, and they try to bring it back and estimate how much in the end kind of your plan is going to have to pay out. So this is just a long-term thing. It's not anything now, but it's just a required thing they just added a couple of years ago that has to be in these financial statements.
How would that compare with other cities of our size?
Your police plan is relatively good off, and your fire plan is a little under just overall, because you basically promised a little bit more. This is basically saying you promised a little more benefits than what you're putting in right now. But you're meeting your required amounts in there. So like most cities, you're meeting your requirements to fund the plan.
There's not a red flag you're raising.
No. I mean, just with the pension plans, the main thing is just to keep them funded and to follow what the actuary requires you to put in there and to meet those obligations on an ongoing basis. Most plans actually have that net pension liability, and if you look at the state of Florida for their retirement plan, they have about $40 million in savings. So yours is nothing compared to that number, but obviously you're a lot smaller than the state, but it's spent quite a few years. Anyways, moving down to the enterprise or the proprietary long-term debt, you can see that there's $3.7 million, and that's mostly made up of your tube, your water, and your sewer bond, revenue bonds there. Overall, the only new debt that you have is related, it's these capital leases you see on these schedules, which are for some new equipment that you guys, new vehicles that you guys have purchased from the year. Under a lease agreement with Ford Credit. Okay, so in summary there, again, looking at all these financial statements, you'll see that, you know, overall the city's governmental position is relatively staying the same. There's a slight decrease in cash and in that position overall, but you're kind of staying on the same plane. Things aren't degrading or anything like that terribly. It's just a slight decrease in some things. On page 82, a listing of all of the federal and state grants that you guys have and the monies that you've expended during the years for these. And you can see here that some of the one of the ones on here for the federal grants is the Hurricane Hermine. So you got some money for that, which was the hurricane related reimbursement that you got back from the federal government. Also, you had a larger grant for your parks that you had built during the year. That's a good way to help bring in some extra capital to help replace equipment and other things like that is to use grants. That's just a summary of those. If you now turn over to page 84. This is the independent auditor's report on internal control over financial reporting and compliance. And this is just a standard disclosure that says that you've got adequate internal controls, but there is a standard disclosure in here that states that, that basically that we prepared your financial statements for you because you don't have a full-time accountant on staff. And as a part of that, you have to have this in there. It's, you know, it says that you acknowledge that on the next page and why. And it's something that's standard in there for a city who doesn't have a CPA on staff. But as I mentioned earlier, Leanne does an amazing job at what she does, and she keeps great records, so that's what keeps us straight here. Okay, turn over to page 87. This is the management letter. This is where we discuss any issues that we found in the audit that aren't material to the overall financial statements. Like I said at the very beginning, you know, the financial statements are the highest level of assurance. Everything is accurately stated in here. It's just this is some issues or things that could be corrected. We didn't have any new findings in this year, but we did find that the finding in the prior year was not corrected regarding inventory and the internal controls over the purchasing department and related to the inventory and stuff like that.
Got a question there.
Mm-hmm.
If it wasn't corrected, why not?
That's something you have to ask management. That
that's something city needs to look at.
Yes, it's definitely something.
Is it continuing?
It was something we found last year.
Okay.
And we discussed last year. That's why it's in here again because it was not corrected during the year.
But it's something we should be aware of.
Yes, you should definitely be aware of.
Okay.
As I said, there are no additional findings outside of that finding, the last year finding. Let's turn over to the next page 88. On here, there's a bunch of standard disclosures on whether, you know, if there was the financial condition. And we determined that the city was not in state of emergency according to Florida statutes. But there are some, you know, concerning financial conditions with the general funds that we noted, and we have a four-year trend here compiled that shows the general fund and the amount that it is has a deficit in each of these 4 years. And you can see it's almost $1 million a year. And these are currently being funded by your proprietary funds, by those transfers we talked about. And if you look down in the text there, so there's 1.22 million average per year that's being transferred from those proprietary funds over to the general funds.
Let me ask a question if I can. On that deteriorating financial conditions, what does that mean as an auditor?
Well, from our perspective, we're just supposed, all we do is we come in, we can tell you what's here, and that there is the general fund has had a history of not being able to meet its obligations on its own. If you took it by itself, it's not stable, but you have to have your enterprise or your proprietary funds to help subsidize those business type activities like water, sewer, gas, and those sales to be able to subsidize this fund. It just is not solid on its own.
How can that be corrected?
Well, I can leave that up to management to decide. I mean, I can't make decisions for you, but it's always a simple math equation. You gotta either increase revenues or decrease expenses, and that's the only way that you can fix, a financial deficit.
Gosh, I was hoping you had the answers.
I wish I had the easy answers. might have to ask God for that one.
Okay.
Well, that's it. That's all I have for you guys. Once again, it's been a pleasure doing you guys' audit. It's always great working with Lynn Ann. She does a good job, and I look forward to hopefully many years to come doing your audit and working on it. And thank you.
Do you give this same type of report to other communities, or how do we compare with other communities you've dealt with?
you guys are friendly enough.
Can I ask him a question?
Mark, you have a question?
The first 2 years your company did the audit,
mm-hmm.
as part of the audit, the man said according to statute and the financial condition of the city that he had to put the city on the governor's default watch list. Is that still the current situation?
I don't think so, not anymore. But that's why we have that that financial condition assessment in there. It's still a public disclosure, for you and anyone who wants to access the report can see that financial position and that issue being on there. But it's just kind of like to let everyone know.
What's the sustainability over, let's say, 10, 20, 30 years of keeping drawing more and more money out of the enterprise funds?
There's no current impact now. It's just the way things are right now. You are solvent, and there isn't any issue with ongoing solvency. Like I said, the total decrease was around $100,000 net between the two. So as long as that is generally pushed back up, that's not a problem. Especially considering your reserves, you've got very substantial reserves, a couple million dollars between the two, and
you talk reserves, what?
The unrestricted balances that can be spent to meet ongoing obligations. So you've got a fair amount of money.
Now, where's the source of that?
That's right in there.
What's the monetary source of that? Those reserves?
Those reserves of past operations of the city. So that's money that's been accumulated over time.
Okay, thank you. Any other questions?
What was the comment? You complimented the city clerk on it. Is she doing a decent job?
Yeah, she's doing a lot of work. She's a hard worker, I'll tell you that. And she does a good job of what she does. Very organized. And I'm always pleased to work with her.
Is your comment really with the city, we're trying to do the best, but we've got some issues?
That's what that one finding is. It's an issue that needs to be corrected eventually.
Don't correct it, what happens?
Eventually the state takes notice. And they investigate it, but that's after a couple of years. I think the third year is usually, this is the second year, so after a third year of it, the state will ask questions about it and maybe try to figure out what's going on. But nothing imminent, this is terrible. You got another year to try to correct the issue.
I would. Yes, thank you, Mayor. still gave Leanne and I the same briefing yesterday, and the finding in the warehouse was not surprised, although it's the third time around.
Jerome, we can't hear you.
I'm sorry.
We can't hear you.
Let me turn the air down.
That's okay, I'll come up front.
Thank you.
Yes.
He had given us the same briefing yesterday about the order, and the finding in the warehouse was not a surprise, as it was the third time. What was surprising was that it had not been corrected, so we were well aware of that already. What we did is sit down, we put together a plan, and we talked, which I'll present to you later. We think that we have some solutions, not at this particular moment, we'd like to discuss them, but we think that there are ways of correcting that. The other part of what might be a concern to the citizens are this, there's also been some changes in revenue based upon what the general fund will be bringing in, starting this fiscal year. And one thing to know is that we eventually want to get to a point where we wean ourselves off of the enterprise fund. Now, the reason the enterprise fund has been so effective is we don't have a tax base, that's a problem. If you raise the millage rate, then you cripple the citizens, which we don't want to do. So in order for you to be able to add revenue to the general fund, you're going to have to find another source to bring it in. We believe we found a couple of things that's going to help. Now, this change will be made overnight, but eventually we'll take less and less from enterprise. But because we are so far into the current fiscal year, getting ready for budget time, if you would, there's no other choice now except to use the enterprise fund again. What we do believe is this time next year, we believe that that will be softened, so that the effect will not be quite so great. But as far as the warehouse goes, we think we've got some solutions, and we'll talk about that probably another meeting if you'd like to attend to that. We think the audit findings were fine, and I asked Cato to personally mention that Leanne does good work, hard work. And because of that, we are solvent as we are. She's got some answers. She has been the mainstay now for about three people here in the last couple of times. So, with that, I think we should all be thankful to say that we've done very well. And I say we, I think that's an individual compliment for her, but thanks to the commission that we're able to have a balanced budget and use of enterprise fund prior to 1 October as required by the governor. We've never gone to a point where we have not. So, again, that's the response. I hope it's explanatory.
Well, I'm going to comment too. We get nothing but compliments on Leanne all the time, so we're very thankful for her and her diligence on the job, so we appreciate it.
Madam Mayor, I ask that we accept the auditor's financial report.
Second.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, sir. Is there any other comments from the commission or anything?
Will we adjourn?